Hi everyone, Bill McCardle here. Welcome to Tampa Bay Nightlife TV. In this week's episode, our good friend Dave Flash Morgan goes down to the new Ringside Cafe in downtown St. Pete, checks out the new digs, and then Angela Austin will go over to the Straz Center in Tampa and check out the Southern Charm Food and Wine Festival. This week's episode of Tampa Bay Nightlife TV starts right now.
Hey, it's the Flash Man with Tampa Bay Nightlife TV, and is that the Ringside Cafe? We better go over there and investigate and see when they're going to be opening up. And what you doing, Tampa Bay? It's the Flash Man. We are in downtown St. Pete today, and I don't know if you remember around the end of January, a lot of people were pretty let down because the Ringside Cafe, the place in downtown St. Pete known for some of the absolute best live entertainment, closed its doors. But guess what? Last week, we got it reopened up here. And where exactly are we? It's Mitch, by the way. Mitch is here. He runs this place like a tight ship. Where are we exactly? Where have we moved?
We're at 350 First Avenue North, downtown St. Pete.
Well, there you go. And I'll tell you right now, if you haven't had the chance, of course, you probably haven't because we just opened last weekend. We've got all new sound. We've got all new lighting in this place. And I'm telling you, you owe it to yourself to get down here. What was the address again?
350 First Avenue North, downtown St. Pete.
So give us a little bit of the history of how you got into the place and what all the great renovations have we got. I'm looking around. It's amazing.
Well, this was the only space available at downtown, so we didn't have to do a lot to it. We threw a coat of paint on it, enlarged a bar, and just rearranged some furniture. And we're, other than, you know, built a stage, new PA and sound, lights, and we're about ready to go.
Now, one of the greatest things, if you remember, about Ringside Cafe was just the amazing view that you had all around the stage. Of course, they're great, known for their great sound and their great lighting. They've redone all of it. Now, what a lot of people want to know is, do you still have that great upstairs view?
Oh, yes, we do. It's even bigger in this location.
So very nice.
It goes all the way around, and you'll be able to see the band on the TVs if you get an obstructed view.
Ah, listen, they've got a video system in the place as well, the Ringside Cafe. I think we're calling it 3.0, aren't we?
Yes, it is 3.0, yes. Third time around.
Third time's a charm is what they say. So get on down here. We've got, of course, an amazing bar staff, so you're going to be treated to your favorite adult beverages here. And so give me some of the lineup. I mean, some of the bands that you got coming in to rekindle the fire, as it were.
Well, rekindle, we do have, we've got T.L. Jensen. We've got 22 N will be here in October. We've got Spasmatics once or twice a month. And we've got a couple new bands for people. We've got Almost There, Nightbreakers, Borderline, a few other bands. No Filter on First Friday.
No Filter. They're great as well. So, and I'm sure you can probably get all of your lineup information there as well.
You just go to our Facebook page. Yeah, right now we're working on a website, but Facebook page is the way to go. They'll have the calendar.
And what is that Facebook on Facebook?
Just Ringside.
How simple is that? Just Ringside. Facebook, check it out right here in downtown St. Pete. Tell us one more time the address.
350 First Avenue North, downtown St. Pete.
Put that in your GPS and get down here.
Hey.
So, as I understand it, even when you get done at First Friday and you sort of disperse and work your way around here, I understand no filter is even going to be here. And as I understand, too, he was pretty intimate in putting the sound system in this place.
Oh, yeah. Derek's been a big help. And No Filter is a great, great band, great show band, entertaining. So it's very First Friday worthy.
Very First Friday. You got to be First Friday worthy to be in the Ringside Cafe on First Friday. So listen, if I happen to be roaming about on Facebook, would I be able to get the lineup there?
Yes, you will. We'll have the calendar on there, plus a little advertisement for each band.
All right, perfect. And I'm sure the website is in development. It'll be coming soon. So check us out at the Ringside Cafe, downtown St. Pete. And the address is
350 First Ave North.
What you doing, Tampa Bay? It's the Flash, man. Coming to you from my favorite spot at the Ringside Cafe. This segment of Tampa Bay Nightlife TV brought to you by
The Corner Bar and Grill in Largo is not just a karaoke bar, it's the karaoke bar in Tampa Bay.
Take my house, take my car, but you can't take my seat.
I don't need this menu, no I don't. I already know just what I want.
I love this bar.
Cause all I wanna do is have some fun. I got a feeling I'm not the only one.
And keeping your safety in mind, the entire corner bar is Cintas certified, electrostatic disinfected regularly, and all microphones are UV cleaned in between singers.
Science.
So come on into the Corner Bar, 2116 East Bay Drive in Largo, serving up good food, great times, and karaoke 7 nights a week. And coming soon, 2 doors down from the Corner Bar, Yardy Vibes Caribbean Soul Kitchen, serving up authentic Jamaican cuisine.
Hey, this is Tom Arnold, and you're watching TampaBayNightlife.tv.
Every week at OCC Roadhouse Museum, Tuesday is country line dancing with a DJ and free lessons starting at 6 p.m. Fun for the whole family. Wednesday is live band country line dancing with free lessons from 6 to 7:30 p.m. and dancing all night. Bring your truck because it's also Tampa Bay's largest truck night. Every Thursday, we host the largest bike night in Florida with over $1,000 in prizes, live bands, burnouts, stunt shows, and more. Weekends are for regional bands and a huge lineup of national recording artists. Get all the info on upcoming bands, tickets, and free concerts at RoadhouseNation.com.
Amortize 5-year debt schedule.
Come a little closer, mom, petit tissue. Feed that fascination if you dare.
Hello, everyone. I'm Angela Austin with TampaBayNightlife.tv. I'm here at the beautiful Straz Center in Tampa at the Southern Charm Food and Wine Gala, benefiting the Greater Brandon Community Foundation. Let's take a look around.
Do you remember when it first died, September? Love was changing the minds, pretender, while chasing the clouds away. Our hearts are ringing in the key that souls are singing as we dance in the night. Remember, while the stars roll the night away.
I'm here with Anne of this beautiful event. Anne, can you tell us the details of what's going on tonight?
I can. This is our Southern Charm Wine and Food Gala. It's our fourth year. Originally, we had it at Tampa Center, and we outgrew that center, so we brought it out to the Straz. Brandon Hyundai is our title sponsor, and they're in our community, and they're a wonderful supporter of the Greater Brandon Community Foundation. We use this event, along with five other ones during the year, to raise money for local charities and families in our community that are hurting. So this event, along with we do a charity golf classic, many, many, many events throughout the year. That's how we raise money for charity. And we'll be presenting checks for $150,000 on November 12th to the charities in our community.
Oh, that is so excellent. Now, you are the president.
I am actually the co-founder and past president. I'm still a trustee, but I'm no longer the president, which is good for me.
Maybe takes a little stress off.
It takes a lot of stress off. And then I can, you know, it takes some stress off me so I can go out and look at other ideas to raise money. For instance, we just won the rights to the 2012 Tampa Bay Wine and Food Festival, which will be held in the fall of 2012. And we're so excited about that. That's a two-day event, probably to come maybe a three-day event. The Bright House Networks is very involved. They've given us up to $500,000 in airtime to showcase our sponsors, and the city of Tampa and the county, you know, they're on board as well, because we want to drive people to our community. We want them to spend their money in the greater Brandon, Tampa area, Eastern Hillsborough County area. So that's going great. So we're looking forward to that in 2012.
And do all ages benefit from this? Children and the elderly alike?
All ages. We have 53 registered charities, and those charities range from the American Cancer Society, Boys and Girls Club, YMCA, Brandon Outreach Clinic, Echo, charities probably that you all have supported your whole life. I mean, we have 53 registered charities. If you're interested, you can see those on our website.
Oh, that's excellent. How many restaurants would you say are representing tonight?
I think we have 21 restaurants tonight.
Oh, wow. What is...
We could have had more. We just didn't have enough room. So.
Well, it is a gorgeous event. Thank you so much, Anne.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
I'm here with Beth. Beth, can you tell me the part you play in this beautiful event?
We are the title sponsor. That would be Brandon Hyundai, which is located on Adamo Drive in Brandon. And we are, like I said, the title sponsor of this wonderful event here.
Now, is this the first year that you've taken part in this charity event?
No, last year we were also the title sponsor, and then we've done numerous things with other foundation events over the past 7 or 8 years.
So this is close to your heart.
Oh my goodness, the foundation is just so wonderful. It's just giving back to the community and to the people who need help and who have let us be in business in Brandon for all these years.
That's excellent. Now, have you had a chance to sample any of this delicious food tonight?
I haven't yet. I have a little bit of Cabernet right now, and that's it. But I do need to get some of the samplings from Maestro's.
Well, Beth, thank you so much.
Thank you. And again, we are Brandon Hyundai on Adamo Drive. Thank you, Brandon.
I'm here with Chris Masada of the St. Pete Times. She is a big supporter of this charity event. Chris, what would you have to say about tonight's events?
Oh, we're very proud at the St. Petersburg Times to be supporting the Brandon Foundation. We're integral in the community. They are integral in the community, and we're just happy to be part of something that benefits the Brandon area.
And what personally led into supporting a charity event like this?
Well, one, philanthropy is significantly important to the Times. We're a wholly owned and Tampa Bay-based business, and we feel it's very important that we give back to the area that supports us.
Oh, definitely. Well, have you had a chance to sample any of the yummy, yummy food?
Not yet, but I'm looking forward to some of the cuisine, the wine, and then, of course, everyone supporting a worthy cause.
I agree. And you look gorgeous, by the way. I love your dress.
Thank you. I appreciate that. It's always lovely to come out and dress up and have an enjoyable time.
It's fun, isn't it?
Yes, it certainly is. It certainly is.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm here with Chris Trottle, who is the president of the foundation. Chris, can you tell me a little bit about the many roles that you play in supporting these beautiful charity events?
Well, really, it's... I'm really just another supporter. You know, we're fortunate to have a lot of good, really good volunteers. a tremendous amount of supporters of businesses. Brandon Hyundai, our title sponsor for tonight, just a great group of people that just really pour their hearts into it and support the community. And it's just really good to work in a community and live in a community where you can see the impact that such a great foundation has. And we can't do it without our supporters and the volunteers that are involved in it.
And can you tell us a little bit personally what led you into this in the beginning?
Well, you know, I've always been involved in different types of charities. This really struck a chord because it was a charity that I lived in the town that it was founded in. Actually, Ann is one of my neighbors. And back in 2005, I got involved with the Charity Golf Classic and just really liked it. And I really liked the fact that I could see the impact that it was having with people in our community. And just sort of grew from there, you know. It started as a supporter and a volunteer and led into me having a bigger role with the foundation. And here we are today.
Okay. So how many years do you think it's been that you've been involved in these charity events?
It's been 6 years, going on 7 years.
Wow. Well, thank you so much for all that you do.
Thank you.
I'm here with Matthew, who's the executive chef of the Hard Rock Cafe. Matthew, what are some of the specials you've got going on tonight?
Well, tonight we're featuring our vegetable spring roll with an avocado ranch dressing or dip. We've also got our signature bruschetta that we've added onto our menu here at the cafe, at the Hard Rock Cafe. It's kind of a twist on our menu items there, kind of liven them up a little bit. We've also got our mini pulled pork sandwich, one of the items that we feature on our menu. And we've also got the local legendary burger, which is basically a take on a Cuban sandwich that we make with a burger. We do our own ground beef in-house, and we do our own special mix on it, so we make it a little bit more special than some of the local of our competition. So it's a great night. We've also featured tonight our Hard Rock Hurricane that we're giving samples of tonight, so everybody comes out and enjoys themselves.
And can we know what's in your Hard Rock Hurricane?
A few secrets there. We want to keep it a signature item, and like I say, it's a little bit different than the normal hurricane. But we'd love everybody to come out and get a sample of it.
Oh, definitely. Looks good. Thank you so much, Matthew.
Thank you very much. Have a good night.
I'm here with Matt, the executive chef of Grillsmith. Matt, what do you have serving up tonight?
Tonight we're doing our voodoo shrimp in a New Orleans-style white barbecue sauce served over a garlic crostini. We also have a lemon feta chicken, which is a lemon butter white wine reduction with diced chicken, sun-dried tomatoes, artichokes, feta cheese, and topped with some basil.
And what makes your voodoo shrimp voodoo?
I guess it's because of the New Orleans style. We just pulled from the whole like voodoo type theme from it. So
it's got a spicy bite to it.
It does. It has a lot of blackening seasoning in it.
That's yummy. So is this your first charity event?
Oh, no. We do these all the time. This is my first one here at the Straz.
And you are the executive chef of Grillsmith. And where is your restaurant located?
Mine's located in the Shops at Wiregrass in Wesley Chapel.
Hey, my name is Sebastian Maniscalco. You are watching TampaBayNightlife.tv. Tune in.
Celebrating Billy Joel, featuring Rob Stringer and Alex D, make their debut at the Billheimer Capitol Theater Sunday, November 13th. This show celebrates the songs and style of Billy Joel, playing international hits like Just the Way You Are, New York State of Mind, Uptown Girl, Vienna, Piano Man, and more. Don't miss Celebrating Billy Joel on Sunday, November 13th. Tickets on sale now at RuthEckardHall.com.
The all-new Liquid Therapy Bar in Pinellas Park is a smoker-friendly neighborhood bar with a big city feel, serving up ice-cold beer, all your favorite mixed drinks, and some pretty amazing food with bike night and live music every Thursday and Saturday night. If you like to sing, we have karaoke every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday with me, the Flash Man. We'll see you at the Liquid Therapy Bar, 6501 Park Boulevard in Pinellas Park. For more information, visit theliquidtherapybar.com.
I'm here with Hillary of Rock Sake. Hillary, can you tell me a little bit about your product?
Well, we have a fabulously made micro-brewed sake that's made right here in the U.S. of A. We make it in Oregon. We have what's known as the Jumai Daiginjo, which is the Rolls Royce of sakes, which is a filtered sake. And then we have a fabulous Nigori, which is an unfiltered sake, which means some of the rice sediment is left into it, and it gives it that cloudy texture and taste. So that's what we're serving tonight, as well as some fabulous effin' cucumber sake teenies.
Well, you sound like quite the connoisseur of sake.
Yes, I am. It's my job.
So what is your favorite recipe to use with the sake?
One of my favorite recipes would definitely be the effin cucumber sake tini. It's so simple. Just a half ounce of effin, little muddled cucumber, some of the Jumai Daiginjo sake, which is right here. And you shake it with a little bit of simple syrup and serve up. Another one of my favorites is a really great twist on a mojito. We do the strawberry cloud mojito, which is made with our unfiltered sake. And we do that with, same way you would make a regular mojito, a little bit of muddled berries, some fresh mint, lime juice, the sake, top it off with some Sprite. You've got a great low-calorie, sulfite-free, gluten-free cocktail.
That's great. Thank you so much, Hillary. That sounds like a tremendous, tremendous sake.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us.
I'm here with Dave of the St. Pete Times. Dave, I hear that you are the artist that arranged all these gorgeous chocolates.
We had a lot of fun here today. We started about noon and we decided to go with this witch theme. How perfect a theme to go here at the Straz Center, Performing Arts Center, to go with a theme knockoff of Wicked, and we just had some fun with it today. So there's great treats, chocolates, cupcakes, a little bit of everything here. But we brought enough for a crowd, so we hope everyone's really hungry.
Can you name off some of these delicious chocolates? I mean, this looks gourmet. I'm looking at, it looks like truffles and
macadamia nut cookies. We have toffee. We have caramel clusters. We have cranberry bark. We have pretzels. There's pedophores. There's cheesecakes. A little bit of everything here today.
Okay, so you know this is every girl's dream, right?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. We hope to have some fun. We want to support the foundation here tonight, and we wanted to put our best foot forward and just have some fun with you.
Oh, it's great. Thank you so much, Dave.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm here with Benito, who is the executive chef of Maestro's. Benito, what do you have serving up tonight?
Tonight, we're really going after the Southern charm, and we've got a couple items. We've got a chipotle shrimp and grits over a sun-dried tomato and Parmesan grits. And then we're also on the other side of the room doing a Carolina pulled pork with a coleslaw topping. And then we're also doing a sweet potato hush puppy with a little bit of honey and bacon.
I like the sweet potato.
Yeah, it's a little different twist to a traditional hush puppy, which is what we try to do here at the Straz with all of our events.
I'm with Melissa and Tony of the Chart House. What do you guys have serving up here? This looks delicious.
This is our crab avocado and mango stack. It's actually a miniature version of one of our signature appetizers. It's a layer of fresh avocado, then a layer of mango relish topped with jumbo lump crab meats tossed in a spicy remoulade sauce.
Wow. Now, is this your first charity event?
We've done a few, but this is definitely one of the best we've done. So we're really having a good time tonight and looking forward to a good turnout.
Excellent. Well, it looks absolutely delicious. And where is your restaurant located?
We are located on the Courtney Campbell Causeway, right across the street from the Westin. We're at 7616 West Courtney Campbell Causeway in Tampa.
And is there a website that we can go to maybe see a menu?
Absolutely. It's chart-house.com.
Now, do you have chef specials that you run every day or specials of the week?
We do a lot of chef's features, as well as we do seasonal promo menus on top of our normal menus as well.
Very nice. And can we also find that on the website?
Absolutely.
Great. Thank you so much, you two. I'm here with Travis of Cigar City Brewing. Travis, what do you got going on here?
Well, we brought out a lot of our local products that we make right here in Tampa for everyone to taste and enjoy tonight. There's a little bit of wine, but we feel like, you know, a little bit of beer kind of fits right in with a little bit of wine.
So your brewery is right here in Tampa?
Right here in Tampa. We're actually located on West Spruce Street, right at that major intersection at Dale Mabry and 275.
And I'm sure there's special secrets that make yours so great.
Our beer is made with love and with a definite nod to the history and the culture of Tampa. Everything that we do kind of reflects our local area, and that's something that's very important to not only the ownership but everybody who works for the brewery as well.
That sounds great. Do you have a website?
We do. It's cigarcitybrewing.com. In fact, we've just rebuilt it, so there's newly updated blogs and product information and everything else. And you can also look and find a lot of the areas where, you know, the retailers that sell it. So
sounds great. Thank you, Travis.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Tuners, and you're watching Tampa Bay Nightlife.tv.
Make sure you follow Tampa Bay Nightlife TV on all the social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.
Well, that's going to do it for this week's show. Thanks for tuning in. Please follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and on YouTube. Subscribe to our YouTube channel because, well, we show things on YouTube that we just can't show on TV. And on that note, please, everyone, be safe. And don't forget to get up, get out, and live it up.